I want to appreciate the presence of my friend Benny Hinn. Just stand up on your feet, Sam. Just come. He's a young man that God is using in a mighty way. Hallelujah. He cleared Form 4 last year, and he has already authored an amazing book. It's called Sprout. I don't know what you are writing after Form 4. I know some of you have those books of lyrics with pictures of secular artists. That is what you are writing after Form 4. Today, men are writing books. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do you want him to say hi? Yes. This guy has won 7 national debates medals. One of the greatest debaters. When I met him, he had been suspended from 7 schools. He had more suspension letters than revision papers. And we began a journey with him, and I like what the Lord is doing in him. He's one of the guys, I know God has called him in the mountain of politics. We are working together. I'm happy to say I led him to Jesus. I'm happy to say that. You can say hi to the people.
Praise God. Amen. Praise God once more. Amen. Chinua Achebe saying that he who wants to eat the sweet yams must be ready to kill the 7 warriors of the 7 mountains and the 7 seas. Walubengo is my name. I'm a corporate speaker, the author of the book called Sprout. I'll just say for 1 minute a story, because the person who published my book comes from this church. It's called Pastor Rashid. When I was working with his book when I was in Form 2, I approached 21 publishers and they told me a young person cannot write a book. So he's the 21 person who accepted. When we wanted to launch this book, we worked with my friend Nixon in 14 hotels, requesting them for a venue to launch the book because the budget was too big. And it costed us 280,000. We went to Safari Park. They said, okay, we are going to give you a venue. But then the last week they told me you'll have to pay this amount of money.
We tried inviting so many people, including the president of Kenya. And we called him more than 19 times every day, because for us, we believe in resilience. Okay, I'm writing this story in my next book, but I learned 5 things. You see, vision, a dream has 5 components. The first component is called imagination. Imagination is a scope that opens you to a reality that is not here, but it is in your mind. And even when we are walking all around, right now I've just done 7 books. Next year I'm launching 5 the same day. And for us, we imagine things and we go for them. Because in life, we don't live by the realities. We live in imagination. I was with this guy in Form 1 in Anesta. And we were inciting people. I was in Anesta for 3 weeks. Then they expelled me. And one thing that I used to tell them, one day I'll be the president. I never knew how I could be a president until when I met Pastor T and accepted Jesus. But that was an imagination that was being said. So the first thing is imagination. The second one is action. After imagination, you now go to action. You won't stop imagining. They say that some dream and sleep, others dream and wake up to chase the dream. Now that is action. The third scope after action is determination. They say that in 1964, Nelson Mandela said in a court, I am ready to live and die for this cause. That was determination. His determination made him live in his reality. The fourth one after determination is passion. As a cruise ship in 1965 had been in a place, in a dock, parked in a dock for 7 years. More than 160 engineers had failed to make the ship. Then a man just showed up and said, you know what, I can fix this ship. Then he took a hammer and knocked and said, okay, you can try moving it. Then it moved. So the owner of the company came and said, how much shall we pay you? Then he said, $20,000. Then they said, no, that is too much. You never did anything. Write for us the criteria on how we shall pay you. Then he wrote a bill and said, $2 for taking the hammer and knocking. $19,998 for taking the hammer and knowing where to knock and how to knock. Then he said, whatever you are saying costed me a small minimum of time. This thing that I did for 30 minutes took me 2 years to prepare. So that one is passion. It is passion that makes you to go to Java instead of going to another restaurant. For this, we just do it with passion. I was given a job as a corporate speaker in Eagles consultancy firm without any degree, without any PhD. And the first day I walked in to give a speech to people of circles, men who have millions of money. And when I stood there, my boss told me, don't tell them your age first, just tell them the content. So I stood there and told them, you know what? My name is Benihin Walubengo. When I stood and addressed the president, I opened with this statement and I saw all of them raise their heads. And after giving a speech for 20 minutes, I could see them write. Then after that, they said, young man, we can even give you a job. Do you have a passport and an ID? I told them, I don't have an ID. That's when they knew that my age. That is passion. Passion will take you to a place where age cannot. Then the last thing, after all this is said and done, you need to have a vision. Because great men only work with a man who has vision. I was given a 2 minutes meeting with a billionaire in this Kenya. And for this, I was just supposed to speak vision. I was not supposed to say, my name is Benny Hino, I was expelled in 7 schools. No, I only had 2 assignments to tell him who I am and where I want to go to. They say that the great days of a man are 2 days. The day you are born and the day you discover why you are born. When you discover those 2 days, you can engage with heavens. So when I met this guy, I told him I want to become president. 1, 2, what do you have to do with my vision? You have money, I have a dream. This dream needs money. So I told him what needs to be done. I'll finish with this quote. I'll not speak about the book because we shall speak about the book later this week at Pastor T's page. But I'll say one thing. Every young person can dream. Every young person can go for whatever they want to go to. But one thing must be there. One thing that I had to learn the hard way is the discipline of sacrifice. I've sacrificed time. I've had sleepless nights. You ask Ken Patrick, I've walked into his place more than 1,000 times when I had 1 trouser and 1 shoe, him advising me about image, yet I don't have any money. But today he's the guy now who is dressing me every week. Because in that time I used to go there and look at those suits and touch them and say, Indo Pastor T wanava. Hey, naka fiti. But I never knew that this thing would come so fast. But I took myself there before it happened. Because I was trying to plant something psychological in my head. I went to Kempinski and asked for water and asked them for a fork, a knife, so that I could know how to handle it. Then one day I found myself in a table where I was supposed to hold them. If I never knew how to hold them, I would have embarrassed myself. So I sacrificed time, I've sacrificed relationship, I broke up with my girlfriend sometimes back. I told her I have to do this. I just took her for a date and told her, ata ukiekewa haga na wekewe state house, utachagua gani. Then she told me, you go and chase your dream. I've sacrificed relationships. Instead of kupostiana status, let me just build time and build capacity. So you'll sacrifice time, you'll sacrifice a relationship. The third thing you'll sacrifice, you'll sacrifice small conversations. One thing I've done, I sit with people like Pastor T, Brian Mwau, Tony Mwangi, PLO Lumumba. Every week I surround myself with an atmosphere of greatness where small conversations can't get into my head. So that when I talk of a conversation of 10 million that I don't have, the atmosphere allows me to talk about it because the people around me have it. So I've sacrificed small conversations. Then the last thing I've sacrificed is the reality of background getting in my head. I've been raised in Babadogo. Babadogo is a slum. But I read books about America. I read books about great places in the world. I'm going to Canada in the next 2 months because I've been reading about Canada, but I've decided now to go to Canada. Because that is the reality of life. To order my book is 500 shillings. I've come with a few copies, but this is me. This is what I do. And one day I'll be sworn in as the president. You'll be a witness. I believe you'll be in my cabinet. Thank you.
I'm still on that girlfriend. Jesus. But there is hope in this nation. Amen. You know, I get excited when I see such people getting the fire. Because we just need one man that can raise a different sound and a generation will be realigned. Hallelujah. So may God bless you, sir. Keep winning. So you see, surround yourself with great people, and you mentioned my name, and you mentioned 10 million. Now you know my security is... we are sorry. Hallelujah. Amen. Can we look at something? But this is amazing, you know. I feel like I need to go back for my school fees. Well, some of us grew up to be adults. So what do you want to be when you grow up? An adult, you know. Jesus.